A mysterious disease is ravaging the third largest barrier reef system in the world, just off the coast of Florida. Thousands of coral are dying at an alarming rate. Our Washington, D.C. Bureau reporter Samantha Jo Roth is taking a closer look at how scientists and lawmakers on Capitol Hill are attempting to understand and stop the outbreak, which has already impacted nearly half of the coral species found on the reef.
Over 5 days, as you can see, it probably maybe 25-30% of the coral, all the way out to pretty much affecting the entire coral head.
Something is killing the coral growing along Florida's coast.
We first observed what they're now calling stony coral tissue loss disease in 2014 around the Key Biscayne area.
What exactly the disease is and why it's occurring is still a mystery to scientists like Jennifer Koss, the director of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration's Coral Reef Conservation Program.
We don't know what it is yet. We don't know if it's a bacteria, a virus, a phage, or a number of different things acting in concert. Florida's corals are already severely stressed. Any other little change, like a new pathogen, can really wreak a lot of havoc.
In the years since its discovery, the disease has spread over 150 square miles.
This has been massive. It's, you know, 22 species in fairly rapid decline once it gets a hold of those corals.
Since scientists don't know how to stop it, they're collaborating to get ahead of it. As you can see in this footage given to us by NOAA.
He's creating a break in there to keep the disease from going from this area to the healthy tissue.
Scientists are treating infected corals with antibiotics and harvesting healthy portions before it's too late.
We now have corals in 13 aquaria around the nation to keep them safe from getting infected. And that will, in essence, be the broodstock that we use to later restore Florida's corals.
It's been 15 years since the Coral Reef Restoration Act expired, and now lawmakers here on Capitol Hill are working to put in place a new plan that would provide federal resources and funding to help save endangered corals.
We have professionals from Moat Marine Institute feel very confident that they could restore a large part of it if given the resources to do so.
The legislation would provide $160 million in federal funding and resources over the next 5 years. And until then, it's a race against time to save the coral from a disease that continues to leave a path of destruction.
It is not contained within Florida. It's now become a Caribbean issue.
In Washington, Samantha Jo Roth, Spectrum.